first person to qualify as an Australian astronaut has just graduated from the European Space Agency. And that means 35-year-old Sydney woman Katherine Bennell-Pegg is ready to undertake a mission to the International Space Station if required.
To be here, knowing that, you know, I've got the astronaut wings on and the Australian flag on my shoulder, it's absolutely incredible. To graduate as an astronaut, especially an Australian astronaut, is a dream come true, bigger than I even had as a kid when I didn't believe I'd ever have the chance to do this as an Australian.
When I dreamed of becoming an astronaut as a child, I never thought it possible to do so representing Australia. I mean, we didn't have a space agency, let alone an astronaut program. So it's a true honour, I would say, to be the first to officially represent Australia. And I'm really determined to not be the last.
She wouldn't be the first Australian in space. Aussie trailblazers Andy Thomas and Paul Scully-Power both went up as American citizens, but she'd be the first to wear an Australian flag on her suit if she's picked for a mission.
You've got wings on your chest, flag on your arm. Have you got your spacesuit yet?
No, the spacesuit would come later, I think, after you're assigned a mission. So that's something to look forward to. I got to try one on when I visited Houston and visited some contractors there and got to try on the new suit for humans going back to the moon. So that was a special day, and they're looking at making them far more for diverse body types and more comfortable than before, so more people can go to space and do good work up there.
The pathway to the stars is still steep, though. Graduating from the space program is no guarantee she'll be picked for a flight to the International Space Station. Only 7 people can be up there at any time.
It's early days. There's no flight yet guaranteed for me. That's not unusual for my class. I'm graduating with 5 others. All 5 of them will go to space by 2030, and I'm so excited to see them go up, and we'll be cheering them on. And who knows, maybe one day I'll see them up there too, but the decision for if or when I fly is a decision for Australia to take in the future when the time becomes right to take it.
Katherine Bennell-Pegg will return to her role as the Director of Space Technology at the Australian Space Agency in Adelaide later in the year.